Hoover, and John J. Laval, regional vice chairman of the New York Republican State Committee and a Donald Trump supporter. Margaret, rewind a little bit. That Hillary Clinton ad, a 60-second spot. It talks about the Access Hollywood tape where Donald Trump brags about being able to grab women in the genitals and get away with it because he's famous. This is the Trump card, no pun intended, that the Clinton campaign can pull. Maybe the last one.
Well, they're betting on it. It's ironic that he happens to be in the Philadelphia suburbs right now, because new polling just came out this morning after that Access Hollywood tape came out, demonstrating that Donald Trump has plummeted there specifically because of that tape. 83% of respondents say they were deeply bothered by seeing that tape. Women have totally shed. I mean, he's hemorrhaging in that part of the region. And so you see them talking about Michigan. You see them talking about New Mexico, because these other states that they have said they needed to win to get to the White House are out of reach now.
It's interesting, though, that this kind of throwing the kitchen sink at it ad. I mean, Alex, let's bring you in on this. You've been doing reporting on the Clinton campaign's kind of posture now in these last 7 days. From what your reporting is, and when you see this ad that they put out today on the heels of the national security ad they put out yesterday, is this a campaign that is confident, or is this a campaign that is nervous?
Oh, I think Margaret really hit the nail on the head there in terms of just how Democrats and how folks who are opposed to Donald Trump see the electoral map at this point. That, you know, you hear Clinton not introducing new arguments against Donald Trump, not going into states where we haven't seen any kind of Democratic presence before. You see her and her allies trying to shore up the strength that they already have. So trying to make sure that women stay where they are and turn out to vote in this campaign. Most of what you hear Democrats doing is aimed at turnout in places like Pennsylvania, North Carolina. We'll see Clinton in Arizona and Ohio again later this week, because the way the math, Kate, is that if basically everything stays as it was a week ago, and you subtract a couple points to factor in any kind of impact from that James Comey letter, she still gets close to or clears 300 electoral votes, which puts her well over the winning number. Now, Donald Trump, because he is kind of backed into a corner just geographically, is trying to test the map in a couple places where we haven't seen things so hotly contested so far. And frankly, we probably won't know whether we get any results from that until Election Day, because it's really too late to see an impact in public polling.
Just 7 days from now. John Jay, the ad that we saw a little clip of it right now, it's Donald Trump's words. So is there anything wrong with it?
The Democrats are desperate. The Clinton campaign's desperate right now. They're falling apart. The early voting, which always favors the Democrats, they're behind where they were in 2012 in early voting in percentages. Yes,
not
they
Trump.
Are.
Not in Colorado.
They're not behind Trump.
Not in Philadelphia.
They're behind where Obama was, and Trump is ahead of where Romney
That's
is. That's
true.
A fact.
It's state by state. Some of the states are different, right? Everything's relative.
North Carolina, percentage-wise, Trump is doing better than
Nevada,
Romney did.
The Democrats feel
Clinton
very confident.
Is doing worse than
Florida,
Obama.
It's somewhere where the Democrats aren't doing as well.
Listen,
but it's a state by
she's
state
buried,
thing.
And, you know, Comey had to come forward and say this to even the tables. She ran around this country telling everyone I was cleared. They found thousands upon thousands of emails that she didn't turn over.
Chief, they found
a lot
650,000 emails that belonged to Anthony Weiner. We don't know how many.
And I will tell you, as the chairman of the largest county in New York,
John, are you not listening to the words coming out of our mouths? We have to fact check you live. Stop.
No.
Stop.
These are facts.
Yes,
and people
there were
are calling
650,000
to
emails related
Clinton,
to Anthony
by the
Weiner's
way.
Investigation.
We're getting
John
a lot of
John
these inquiries.
You know I love you, but stop it right now. There are 650,000 emails related to the Anthony Weiner investigation. We do not know if they are related to Hillary Clinton. We do not know what percentage is related at all to Hillary Clinton, what went through Hillary Clinton's server. We don't know anything. Stick with the facts.
It
you guys have a good argument without taking
Jim
the lead.
Jim Comey is going to make that announcement when not some of those 650,000 emails pertain to Hillary Clinton. And I'm going to bet right now that there are secure emails that are on those.
Well, but you don't know, and again, you don't know how many. Mr. Levine, Mayor, go ahead.
Well, you know, it's incredible. John is the chair of the Republican Party of New York, and hear what he just said? It was John, the FBI director, had to come in to turn the tables. That's what the head of the Republican Party of New York just said on TV, on CNN. And the people of South Florida, who come from countries like Venezuela, where they've actually seen law enforcement turn the table for elections should be highly concerned based on what we just heard.
Hang on now.
I don't believe the FBI director.
Are you saying the FBI director is acting like he's in a junta in South America?
I actually do not believe the FBI director did this on purpose. I think he's a good guy that made a very poor decision. Over 100 attorney generals came forward and have said this was a bad decision by the FBI. Listen, we know what's going on with the Russian hacking. Why did he release the Russian hacking information? Totally connected to Donald Trump's campaign. I mean, how would we feel if the IRS commissioner came out right now and said, I feel obligated to release Donald Trump's tax returns? Do you think that would tilt the scale?
Comey should not have come out and said Clinton is cleared because he was wrong then. He was going to be wrong in the end when we find that there was criminal activity.
It was a bad decision.
They're
not going to focus on emails.
So is everything you're saying.
Now look, it's a huge amount of conjecture from both sides here. I mean, look, what I hope Republicans who are wondering what the heck has happened to our party and what the heck is going on in this election, hear some of these resonant arguments, right? I feel like I'm living in this deja vu nightmare. In 2012, the Republican Party was telling us we were going to win. Mitt Romney was going to win in Michigan. Mitt Romney was making serious inroads in Pennsylvania. Look,
Minnesota.
We don't have enough Republican voters to win an election. We have to win in. We have to win women. We have to win Hispanics. We have to win minorities. We're not winning in any of those areas, y'all. We need to really rethink what this party stands for and really start selling it on national elections. Trying to get the FBI director to be on your side, on either side, this is not what American justice is.
That is not
is.
What
this
I said.
This is what you're saying. You're saying he's
not
in
at
it
all.
To help. He turned
what I heard.
The table.
He came out and said she was cleared. He was mistaken. He needed to correct that wrong. Now the tables are even.
The tables are even.
Now it's time for him to step out. And Hillary Clinton says,
Let's do this. Let's move to a different subject to see if we can do one at a time on this one.
Sure.
Alex Burns.
Good luck.
Alex Burns, you are in a safe, undisclosed location.